Hello, my dear students. Hope you have started being regular with your studies. Every day you are getting the PDF work along with the video. So please, it's my humble request, don't leave any work for tomorrow. Because if you will not complete the PDF work on the same day, because maximum you are getting only 4 PDF every day. So if you are going to leave any of the PDF for tomorrow, next day again you will get the PDF and at the last moment you are going to be overburdened with a lot of work. So all the work will be going to be compiled together and we don't know when the government will announce to reopen the school. And once the school will reopen, we will expect that your all work should be complete. And that time you can't say that Miss has rubbed the board, so I was not able to complete the work, this and that. No excuses will be acceptable that time because you are having the PDF and enough time to complete the work. So I am expecting that you will keep update yourself with the work and as per as the study. So today we are going to start the new topic, time. And before you start the time lesson, please complete each and everything which PDF we send about the money, and then you start the time lesson from the new chapter. When you are going to, since if we are uploading the PDF and a video today, so you will put the date today's in the copy. Today's date you will put in the copy so that we will come to know that you have done the work on the same day or not. So before we start the topic, just recapitulating whatever you studied in class 4 about the time. We know about the time, how to read the time, how to see the clock. There are two types of clock. One is digital clock and second one is analog clock. Generally at every home this is an analog clock, and this type of clock in which you are getting the time in a digital way, this is called digital clock. These two type of clocks, maximum people are having this clock, and this is available in the mobile. Okay, so we will not see the digital clock because it is you already knowing. We will come to the just recapitulating that what is this analog clock. Analog clock, you know that there are 12 divisions, and in 12 divisions it is divided into 4 parts as in the red fraction. That if we divide a whole into 4 equal parts, each part is called 1/4, and that is a quarter. So we read the time in such a way, this is 3 o'clock. Okay. When this minute hand is at 3, it will be 3:15. So this is known as quarter past. It's just recapitulating you. Quarter past 3. If it is at 6:01, it is 3:30, and this will be half past 3. If this is reaching to this one, 45, this is 3:45, and this is called quarter to 4. Okay? This is just a simple thing what you studied in class 4. Why this is quarter 2 and why this is half past and quarter past? When we divide this clock into 2 equal parts, this is the right part and this is the left part. Whenever the minute hand is towards the left side, we are reading it as a past. This much is over. Okay? After 3 o'clock, this much time is over. Now, when we are moving towards the left side, we will count it as a, this minute is left to complete the next hour. That is after 3, it will be 4. So, if it is at 7, we will count it 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 minutes to 4. If it is at 8, 5, 10, 15, 20, 20 minutes to 4. Similarly, when it is at 9, it is 15 minutes, and that 15 minutes is known as a quarter. Got it? So, whenever the minute hand is towards the left side of the clock, we will read it as a quarter to, or 10 minutes to, or 15 minutes to, like that we will read it. But whenever the minute hand is towards the right side, we will read it out 5 minutes past 3, 12 minutes past 5, like this we read. So, while reading the 2-1, we will make sure with whatever the place the hour hand is, This is the R hand. If the R hand is between 4 and 5, then we will consider at 2 in case then it will be 5, not 4. Okay? When it is moving towards 4, so we will read it as if, sorry, from 4 to 5, we will count it as if 5, not 4. Clear? So, 2 ke case mein 1 plus we are adding whatever the minute hour hand is there, and in case of past, the same time we are reading it. This much we studied in the class 4. Now we are switching to the 24 hour clock timing. The same 12 hour clock timing we have studied that AM and PM. AM stands for anti-meridian, that is before noon, and PM stands for post-meridian, that is afternoon. Okay, so when it is AM and PM, after 12 noon, if you will see that one day is equal to 24 hour. Okay, so after 12 noon, we will count it 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 20, 21, 22, 23, and at 12 it will be going to turn to 00. Why? Because at 24 hour the new day will start. So 12:00 means it is 12 midnight, and at 12 midnight it will, the clock will complete one full rotation, then it start again from 1, not from 24 to 25. Got it? So we will not write there 24, we will write there 00. Clear to everyone? So this is called the 24 hour clock timing. Now, where we use this 24 hour clock time? At the airport or a railway station, you might have seen this one, that the train will arrive at 13:04 hour. So what is this 13:04? 13 means the after 12 it reaches to 13, means 1:10 PM. Okay, so whenever the timing is written like this, 08:45 hours, it is less than 12, so it will be 8:45 AM. But if it is written 19:30 hours, 19:30 is more than 12, so we will write it down. 19 minus 12, it is 7:30 PM. Okay? Similarly, if it is written 12:30 hours, so it is 12:30 PM. If it is written 00:15 hour, it is 12:15 AM. So this is clear to you all. This all you have studied in class 4. I am just recapitulating it. Now we are moving to the exercise of the book work, that exercise 16.1, convert the higher unit into the lower unit. Now while converting, we should know the conversion table as well. So there are these tables is there. Till now you might have studied that one, there are two type of year, one is ordinary year and second one is leap year. But while converting the time chapter, we will not going to consider as a leap year or ordinary year until and unless it is not asked in the question. We will take it as a ordinary year only and always consider it as a 12 month or 365 days while conversion. Okay. In case if it is given in the question that convert 7 year into how many days if it is a one year is a leap year or 2 year is a leap year. It's like that if they are saying, in that case we will consider 1 year as a leap year. Otherwise we will generally take it as a 365 days only. Okay. The second one is coming, 1 month is for 230 days. We know that 1 month is, there are 12 year and in there are 7 year when the, it has, there are 7 year when it is having the 31 days and 5 year when it is having a, 30 m. So 4 year is having 30 days, 7 year is having 31 days, and 1 February is having 28 or 29 days according to the leap year. In leap year it has 29 days. In ordinary year it has 28 days. Okay, this much you already knowing it. So how we will convert it? Because they will not give you it is a 31 days or it is August month or it is September. They will ask you 7 month is equal to how many days. So in our general way, we are not taking it as 31, 29, 28. We will take it as a 30 days. Okay, we are taking as an average number, that is 30 days. Okay, so then next is 1 week is equal to 7 days, and we are taking 1 month is equal to 4 weeks. We will not take some month is having 5 weeks, some month is having 4 weeks. So we will not divide it into 5 and 4. We will take in an average, and that is the 4 weeks. So this is the common points which we can remember in the conversion. And whenever we are converting a higher unit to lower unit, we used to multiply. And when we are converting lower unit to higher unit, we used to divide. So we are going to start with the exercise 16.1. The question which I am solving on the board, you need not to solve. You just solve the questions which is given in the PDF and which I give you as a homework. So first question, it is given, convert into days, 4 weeks, 7 days. Okay, so first we convert into the week. So we have to write down the table here. 1 week is equal to 7 days. It is important to write this thing, whatever you are converting. So 4 weeks plus 7 days. Because weeks and days, they both are two separate units, so we will put the add here, and then we will only convert to the weeks, we will not convert to the days, because already it is given that. So 4 multiplied by 7 plus 7 days. So 4, 7 here, 28 plus 7 days. 28 plus 7, 35. And this is the answer. Now we are moving to the question number 2. Question number 2 is asking convert into hours. So 12 weeks, 7 days, 14 hours. Since we have lack of time, so we are not able to solve each and every question. So I am taking the lengthiest one. In case if you are facing trouble in any of the question other than the PDF work, feel free to inform your class teacher. I will be available there. Or whenever the school will reopen, I will clear your doubt. Okay? So first, this is week, this is days, and this is hour. And we have to convert into the hours. So we will move step by step. First, we convert week into days. Then we convert days into hour. So there are 3 steps, and each step is having 1 mark. So don't do anything directly. You have to move step by step. So first you will write down here, 1 week is equal to 7 days. Okay, so 12 multiplied by 7 plus 7 days plus 40 hours. We will not touch the hours because it is already converted into hours, so don't have to convert again. So 12 7 jar 84. Plus 7 days plus 14 hours, it is equal to 91 days and plus 14 hours. We know that 1 day is equal to 24 hours, so we will convert it. 91 multiplied by 24 plus 40 hours. Since there is no place, I am doing it here. 24 into 91, as you remember I explained in the class, if you are not comfortable to multiply it mentally, make a rough column and then multiply. Since I can multiply it mentally, so I am doing it here. 91 into 24, 24 carry 2, and 24 9 are 216,
इक्वल टू 280 प्लस 14 आवर्स. I am moving from here to here. Now we will add it. 4 plus 4, 8. 8 plus 1, 9. 2198 hours.
Okay. Again I am repeating. If you are not able to multiply mentally, make a rough column and multiply it there.
Because I am having lack of time, so I don't have time to spend. So I am making a rough column. 91 into 24, you know how to multiply. Please multiply and check your answer. Now question number 3 is convert into minutes. It is given 9 hours 40 minutes. So first we will write down the table. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Okay, so this implies 9 hours plus 40 minutes is equal to 9 multiplied by 60 plus 40 minutes. 9 6 54. And if you remember, multiply by 10, what we are doing? We will multiply the numbers and then putting 10. Okay? So 9 6 54 and put 10 here is 540 plus 40 minute. This is 540 plus 40, 580 minutes. Clear?
Beta, I am repeating again and again. If you are not able to do it horizontally or vertically mentally, please make a rough column and do it as you can do.
Next one we have to convert it into the second. Okay, so we know that first we have to convert hour into minute and then minute we have to convert into the second. Again, three steps are there. So first step, we will write down 1 hour is equal to 60 minute and 1 minute is equal to 60 second. So we will write down here 8 hours plus 40 minute plus 25 second. All three are different variables, so we will separate it. First we convert and then we will add. Okay? So 8 multiplied by 60 plus 40 plus 25 second. Sorry. 40 minute plus 25 second. So 8 6 is 48, 480 plus 40 minute plus 25 second. So 48, 8 plus 4, 12, carry 1, 4, 1, 5. 520 minute multiplied by 60 plus 25 seconds. I'm sorry, this is not minute. 520 multiplied by 60 is 10. 520 minute plus 25 seconds. Next step we will multiply it. So 520 multiplied by 60 plus 25 seconds. Then, when we multiply it by this one, so 10 and 20, we will write down 20 here and multiply this number by this number. So 6 2s are 12, carry 1, 6 5s are 30 and 1, 31 plus 25 second. Now you add it, 1 space will be 0 plus 5, 5, 0 plus 2, 2. 1, 3, and since it is a bigger number more than 4 digits, so we will mark the period. So answer is 31,225 seconds.
This is all about this exercise 16.1. All the questions we have completed in the PDF, and I will request everyone to complete the work from PDF in your classwork copy in a neat handwriting as I explained. And the homework I am going to write on the board, that homework also you have to do. Okay, the homework is only one question, that is question number 5A, you have to do in copy. So your homework is, I am writing here, question number 5A in copy. All the best, dear children. Again, I am repeating, don't leave any work for tomorrow. The day when you are receiving the PDF, please complete the work on the same day itself so that you are at the last, you are not going to be overburdened with the pile of work. All the best. Good day to you all.